Assalamu alaikum. In today's discussion, we shall talk about two very important and useful DC motors. These are the stepper motors and the brushless DC motors. So we start our discussion with stepper motors. Stepper motors are DC motors which rotate in steps, and whenever there appears a pulse at the control input of the motor, then rotor rotates by certain degree, and the step size by which this rotor rotates, that depends upon the construction of this stepper motor. The rotor of this stepper motor generally consists of a permanent magnet with north and south pole, and on the stator there are multiple coils, and these coils are connected through a control unit to a DC voltage source. So what does this control unit do is that it connects one of these coils at a time with this DC voltage source. For example, if initially rotor is at this location, and when this pulse arises at this control input, this control unit will connect this DC voltage source with these two wires, that is, one end, this positive end will be connected with A, and the negative end of this voltage source will be connected with A dash. So this you already know, these are coils with multiple turns, and two sides of these coils, one side of the coil, second side of the coil, at the back end these two coils are connected, and at the front end these are two wires coming out of this coil, and these are connected with this DC voltage source. So when this coil A dash is connected with this voltage source, current will start flowing in this coil. The direction of current is this one. So due to this current in the coil, a magnetic field will be produced. The direction of magnetic field can be easily determined by the right hand rule. If we curl the finger in the direction of current, thumb will indicate the direction of flux density vector. So current is entering the coil from this end, so and leaving the coil from this end. So flux density vector due to this coil, that is in this direction. So now there are two magnetic fields, flux density vector due to this permanent magnet and flux density vector due to current in this loop. Due to these two flux density vectors, due to interaction between the two magnetic fields, a torque will be induced, and that torque will tend to align the two magnetic fields. This situation is exactly the same as if when you place two magnets in vicinity of each other, these two tend to align with each other. For example, if we have this magnet north pole and south pole, and you place a magnet over here with certain orientation, it will quickly align itself with the magnetic field. The same situation will appear over here, and same is the case in synchronous motor. In synchronous motor, the same is situation. We have two flux density vectors, one due to stator and another due to rotor, and both tend to align with each other. The only difference is that in case of synchronous motors, this stator flux density vector, that is rotating with synchronous speed, because these coils are supplied with three phase currents, and that produces a uniform rotating magnetic field. Here magnetic field is not rotating because only one coil is excited and it is supplied with DC currents. So this is the orientation of VS is not changed until we excite some other coil. So therefore, due to induced torque, rotor will align itself with this stator flux density vector, and it will reach to this position. This rotor will stay at this position until there comes a second pulse at the control input, and when this second pulse appears at this control input, what will happen is that this coil will be disconnected from this voltage source, and another coil will be connected such that this will be the situation. Coil C, C dash will be connected to this voltage source to move it this BS from this orientation to this orientation. So here this positive end of this voltage source is connected with the C dash, and negative end is connected with C. So this will be now the current. Current will be entering from this coil and leaving from this coil. So flux density vector is in this direction. So again, this rotor will rotate to new orientation, and when another pulse arrives at the control input, this will be the situation. BS will now rotate to this location. That is, you will be exciting this coil B dash. Current positive end of the voltage source connected over here, negative end connected over here. So this will be BS, and again rotor will align itself with BS. So here is the sequence of voltages which will be connected to these coils. Initially, when pulse 1 comes, VA, this coil is excited and is supplied with this DC voltage source, is connected with DC voltage source, and these two coils are not excited. When the second pulse comes, what was situation? This coil C was excited and it was supplied with a negative voltage. This C dash was connected to positive end and C was connected to negative end, and rest of the two coils are not excited. With the third pulse, this coil B was excited and it was supplied with DC voltage, and this sequence will continue for the fourth pulse and fifth pulse and sixth pulse. With the fourth pulse, this will stator magnetic field will rotate to this orientation. That is, this coil A dash, that is connected to voltage source, but now with opposite polarity. Current entering here, leaving here, so that flux density vector is over here, and rotor will align itself with the stator flux density vector. So with fourth pulse, we connect here VDC, and this is zero. With the fifth pulse, this will be the flux density vector. That is, coil C and C dash is excited with positive end over here at C. So this is VDC, and here is zero, and here is zero. For the sixth pulse, we have again the first initial situation. That is, we excite coil B dash and V. So coil B is now excited, and A and C are not excited. And then this sequence will repeat itself with the next pulse when pulse number 7 comes. So what is step size for the rotor? In this particular construction, step size is equal to 60 degrees. We can further refine this step size by improving the construction of this machine. For example, we can change the number of poles, and we can furthermore change the number of coils on the stator. This stator with three coils, that is called a three-phase stator, and we can for example have a six-phase stator, that is this stator. So here, instead of three coils, we have six coils, and now how much will be the step size? For example, if this coil is excited, this will be the flux density vector in this direction, and then at the next time instant, this coil will be excited and the flux density vector will be this one. So now the step size will be 30 degrees. Similarly, step size can be improved by using multiple poles on the rotor. Here it was two pole rotor, we can have four pole rotor as well as 8 pole rotor and so on. And therefore step size, this was for 2 pole, and step size will be 30 degrees for 4 poles, and it will be 15 degrees for 8 poles. And furthermore, step size can be changed by having more number of coils on the stator. And for this particular configuration, we need 6 pulses for one complete rotation of this rotor. 60 degrees for one pulse, so 360 degrees for 6 pulses. So this NM, that is equal to 1 by 6 into number of pulses for this machine. Are simple for 2 poles machine, this expression can be written in this form, 3 multiplied by P. 2 poles, and then 2 multiplied by 3 is 6. So for 6 pulses, there will be one complete revolution rotation of the rotor. And this P is for number of poles on the rotor. And this formula is for the machine with 3 coils on the stator. If we have more coils on the stator, then this is the expression, more appropriate expression. Let me write it over here. So here N is number of coils, number of phases to be more precise. Here for 3 coils machine, we have this relation with 2 poles, and in general N coils and P poles, then number of pulses is related with number of revolutions of the motor with this expression.